Hello childrens, greetings to you all. Hope you all are safe by God's grace. Today we are going to see the unit 5 in mathematics. Chapter name is coordinate geometry. In coordinate geometry, the very first exercise belongs to graph. So I am going to do it in graph notebook. Kindly take your graph notebook, pencil, scale and everything and keep it ready. In coordinate geometry, the introduction part is nothing but abscissa and ordinate. What is meant by abscissa? What is meant by ordinate? We'll see with the question. The very first question I have written here, plot the following points in the coordinate system and identify the quadrants. In that we have, they have given up plotting the points, P point -7, 6, Q 7, -2, like that they have given a values. We are going to plot the points. While plotting the plots, this is our x coordinate, this is our y coordinate. X comma y is nothing but a points. This x coordinate is said to be abscissa, y coordinate is said to be ordinate. X coordinate, here I'll write here x coordinate is abscissa. X coordinate is nothing but abscissa. Y coordinate is called ordinate. So we are going to draw, we are going to plot the points in the graph notebook. Many doesn't know how to draw x-axis and y-axis. Now I'll show you. This box is contained 1 centimeter. In the box, this box is nothing but 1 centimeter. We have to draw in a thick line. We should not draw in between the thick line. We should draw only in the thick line. See how I am drawing. The one box should be fully completed. So I am taking this full box and I am drawing like this. Here the biggest number is 9. So we can draw little more. Then this is our y-axis. This also we have to draw in a midline, thick line only we should draw. We should not draw in the small lines. We should draw only in the thick line. This is our x-axis. This is our x dash. That means my negative value. This is our y dash value. So we'll see with the values. All the values should be within the box so that we won't be able to get any confusion. So this projection is meant for this. In this place 1 belongs to, this projection belongs to 2, this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So here I am going to write -1, minus, see where I have written minus so that it won't get disturbance. -3, -4, -5, -6, -7. Same way I am going to write. In this side we have only negative value. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have up to 9 value. Y coordinate we have 9. So I am just increasing 9. Here also I can write. Here -1. See, within a box we should finish writing it. -5, -6, -7, -8, -9. So this is my y axis. This is my y dash. This is my y dash. And here this is my y axis. So next we are going to plot the points. First point is -7, 6. Where is my -7 in the x-axis? See, it is here. -7. And then, see, you have to keep a scale like this. -7. And where is my y? 6. In this y value, we have positive 6 here. So, the connecting point. The connecting point is said to be our value. So, P is -7, 6. Here, I am using pen because the visual should be bright. You should use only pencil in this page. In this graph page only you should write in pencil. Next, Q point is 7, -2. Q is 7. this is positive 7. So in this side, positive 7 is here. Keep the scale here. And negative is minus 2. In negative, we have minus 2 this side. So this connecting point is 7, minus 2. You have to take and write 7, minus 2. Then R, minus 6, minus 7. So minus 6, where is our minus 6? Minus 6 is here. Where is my y value? Minus 7 is here. Y minus y, 7 is here. So down. So we can connect this point. So this is my R value. Minus 6, minus 7. Then my S is 3, 5. Where is my 3 x-axis? X-axis 3 is here. Y-axis 5 is in the upper side. So we can just use a scale to identify easily. So this is my S. S 3, 5. Then T. T 3, 9. See, again my 3 is in the here only. Where is my 9? Positive 9 in the upper side. This side. So I have plotted my values. So after plotting my values, what is the important thing to be written? Scale. We should write our scale. How to write scale? X-axis and Y-axis we have drawn. In this X-axis, one number only, it is increasing in Y-axis as well as in the X-axis. So we should write 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. Same way, Y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. Yes, we have completed the first sum. Now we are going to do the second sum. Second sum is your homework sum. The graph they have already drawn in your textbook. In your textbook itself, they have drawn a graph. I'll show you. See, in this textbook, page number 192, the graph is drawn. You have to just mark what it is. What is x-axis, what is y-axis. You have to mark it and do it as a homework. Next, third question. Plot the following points. I've written here, plot the following points in the coordinate plane and join them. Coordinate planes and then join them. What is your conclusion about the resulting diagram? Resulting diagram, what shape you are getting, you have to write. So here, this is two subdivisions are there. Here I have separated the notebook and I have drawn a x-axis, y-axis and kept ready for your video. So here I am going to join it. Minus 5, 3. Where is minus 5? This side. X-axis. Then where is our 3? Positive 3. See here. So this is my minus 5, 3. Then minus 1, 3. Here minus 1 is there. And my 3 is, positive 3 is in the upper side. So I can write minus 1, 3. Then 0, 3. 0 is here. My y-axis 3. Where is my y-axis 3? So it is lies here. Y-axis 3. 0, 3. Next is 5, 3. Positive 5 is there. And positive y is here. So the connecting thing is here. So what we are getting here now? We are getting a straight line. Join. Construct a plane. Plot the plane and join them, they have said. So I am going to join it here. If I join, what I am getting? I am getting a straight line. So you can write here as the resulting diagram. Resulting diagram is a straight line. Is a straight line. That's all. Same way, scale you should write. X-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. Y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. Same way, the second subdivision. 0, minus 4. 0, minus 4, 0, minus 2, 0, 4, 0, 5. All x-axis is 0. So, 0. Where minus 4 will come? It is here. It is in the down. Minus 4 is coming down. Minus 4 is coming down. So, I can plot here. Then 0, minus 2. 0 is here. Minus 2 is here. So, I am plotting here. Then, you can write here. 0, minus 4. 0, minus 2. Then 0, 4. 0, 4. Then 0, 5. 0 is here. 5 I can write here. So 0, 5. So I am plotting in. Where I am plotting? I am plotting in the y-axis. I am plotting in y-axis. The resulting diagram, the points lies in the y-axis. The resulting diagram is, see, the resulting diagram. For all the points lies in y-axis. All the points lies in y-axis. Same way, previously we have done this sum. Can you say what is the thing here, x-axis, and the line is going in the upward direction in the straight line? It is parallel, right? So we can say that it is a straight line, and it is, and the line, and it is parallel. We can write the symbol like that, parallel to x-axis. This line is parallel to x-axis. So that's all. So our third sum and fourth sum we have finished. So we should not draw it again. So all the points are in the same line. So we can wind up. Next, fourth question. Plot the following points in the coordinate plane. Join them in order. What type of geometrical shape is formed? So join it and see what type of shape you are getting it. So 0, 0. 0, 0 will come here only. X-axis and y-axis. Then -4, 0. X is -4. So -4 and y is 0. So in this line itself you will get. So 0, 0 lies here. -4, 0 comes here. Next -4, -4. Here -4. My y-axis -4 is coming down. So -4, -4. Then 0, -4. Then 0 is here. -4 is here. So 0, -4. Join all the points and see what shape you are getting. Yes, I am joining it. Yes, this side 1, 2, 3, 4 box. This side 1, 2, 3, 4 box. 1, 2, 3, 4 box. This side also 4. All sides are equal. 4, 4 centimeter is there. That means the shape geometrical shape is square. You can write here as geometrical shape is square. That's all. Next scale. Next, this is our second subdivision. -3, -3, 2, 3, -6, -1, 5, -1. So we can plot now. -3, 3. -3 is here and +3 is here. So you can plot here. -3. Next is 2, 3. +2. That means this side. 2, 3. 2, 3. Then -6, -1. So -6 is here, -1 is here. See, if my number is exceeded this one box, if the number is exceeded this one box, I cannot plot this point. That's why I told you to write the numbers within a box. Clear? So -6, -1. Then 5, -1. 5 is here and -1 is here. So 5, -1. So now we are going to join all the dots. Use your pencil to draw, children. Yes. See what shape we are getting it. Join it properly in the same thick line. So I am getting a trapezium shape. So you can write here as a geometrical shape is trapezium. Trapezium spelling is TRAPEZIUM. Trapezium. For all the sums, scale must be written. Scale x-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. Y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. If you increase the centimeter in x-axis or y-axis, according to that you should change it. Clear? Now we have completed these three sums. First sum we have done it here. Yes, you can view it properly and do the sum. This is just plotting the points, that's all. Next, third sum, we have two subdivisions. First subdivision, I have done it here. The line is parallel to x-axis. And the second subdivisions, we have done it Yes, y-axis. All the points lies in the same line. So all the points lies in y-axis. Y line. It is coming. All the points coming in y-axis. So I have written all the points lies in y-axis. Next, fourth question. First subdivision. Geometrical shape is square. After plotting them, we got a shape as square. Next, for the fourth sum, fourth subdivision, second subdivision. After joining all the points, we get a shape called trapezium. So we have completed exercise 5.1. Do the second sum as homework. Your homework is second sum. Do it in textbook. Thank you, children. We'll meet you in the next video. Thank you so much.